Hi, everybody. This is Dixon.
And I'm Jose.
And welcome to the May 2022 episode of Southwest Side Stories. So we've got a delicious episode today because we're going to be talking to none other than Dolores Zaragoza Lopez, who is the co-owner of De Colores Ice Cream and Coffee in Archer Heights. De Colores is recently reopened for the spring and summer, which is great because it's been sort of a miserable April and spring so far. And I'm definitely looking forward to it getting warmer and warm enough for ice cream. But, you know, this is an institution in the neighborhood. Jose, you're going to be talking to Dolores. Can you talk a little bit about what you're interested in learning about the business?
Yeah, I mean, you know, like you said, they've become an institution these past couple of years. There hasn't been a whole lot of sit down, like third place spots in the neighborhood or somewhere you can just kind of sit and conversate. Not a lot of cafes. So just the fact that they cater to, you know, they have a lot of ice cream and, a lot of Mexican savory treats for like younger people. There's Curie High School's right by there. But it's also become like a nice sit down place for like older folks who just actually have a place to have a conversation. So, I'm excited that they're reopening now for the season.
Yeah, for sure. I actually did have a concha from there the other day and it was very good. But you talked about them becoming an institution over the years, and they certainly have. But obviously the last couple of years have really put a damper on restaurants and sit down places in general. So I'm curious, from learning from your conversation, how they've navigated the pandemic, how they've adjusted to, you know, all of the different rules and regulations that have come with COVID and social distancing, and, you know, what they're doing now, 2 years into COVID.
Yeah, you know, definitely want to ask them, you know, how COVID's been treating them. There was also incidences at the shop. There was a break-in that made, you know, the local news last fall, which made them close for the winter. I'm really just happy to learn about, you know, this family business's history, how they've established themselves, because they've been so helpful to so many community groups. You know, they've helped the Southwest Collective with the food drive when we were doing mutual aid, you know, during COVID, the COVID response. And they've been helpful just hosting meetings, when the shops closed, opening for meetings, for groups, just as a nexus to handing out, you know, buy one, get one free coupons for school events and things like that. They've been just a great asset. So really looking forward to hearing more from the family and what their plans are for this summer as they open up again.
Okay, my name is Dolores Lopez, and we started our business back in 2009. Me and my family started the business. And we started as an ice cream shop. We noticed that having so many schools around the area, and there was not an ice cream shop, a place where the students could go and just sit down with friends and maybe do some homework or just wait for their parents to pick them up. I had a very good relationship with Curie High School. I was an LSE member. And that's when I noticed that we were lacking spaces for students in some of the businesses. I can understand that sometimes they get scared about the high school students because they're so loud and everything, but they're really nice. So when we opened, we were focusing more on the students, like to offer our space for students. And we started with, regular things that a student or a teenager like the ice cream, some snacks, some chips, some sodas, and a safe space for them to be in the community.
It's been great watching, your business kind of like flourish and change and different things get added to it. How has that been,
we're kind of familiar with your family that helps run the, everyone runs the business here?
Yes, we started, me and my husband, I'm the front face, but I have three daughters, and the youngest was 5 years old when we started the business. So they all help, like, to do the ice cream or to get the paletas ready and everything, and restocking, and my husband going to the store to buy all the things that we need. So this is a family business.
You know, small businesses are such a such a risk and such a endeavor, and that you've always, you know, through all that struggle, this has always been such a family friendly, inviting space for new families, for young families, for people. But during COVID, it seemed like all businesses were really struggling, and I don't know how were you guys adjusting to that?
COVID. Yeah. It's being a small business, a family-owned business, it's hard, you know? So when COVID came, it was definitely time-proving. Because it was really, really hard for us to keep it open. And I know you heard about a lot of government help for the small businesses. We applied for everything that we could, and we got nothing. For so many reasons, it was so many excuses. You don't have payroll, or you don't have this, or you need that. I mean, they asked for so many papers and records and everything, and we tried to have everything. But even though we have most of the things, they didn't get the support for nothing. So, but luckily we rely on the community, like coming and you know, keep us in their eye and coming to our business. And we have some help from Chamber of Commerce in Little Village. They give us a small, it could be a small grant of $3,000, but it was huge in that time for us. And then the teachers at Curie High School again, they got together and they put some money together and they give us some money. So we got help for it, you know, in our community.
Yeah.
So, and it's been hard, but my husband has another job. So if it wasn't for that, we couldn't keep it open. So I wanted to keep it open for my community, the teachers, the students, the families that are around there. So it's been so hard. This is going to be, 2022 is going to be a very critical year. Not only for me, I think for most of the businesses that we try to keep them open. Mm-hmm. Because 2020, COVID came, and then 2021, we had the hopes that we're gonna do better, and it was not what happened.
Yeah.
2022, it's gonna be a critical year. And then also because the supply chain, so it's not only people is losing their jobs or getting less hours, or they're being more careful how they spend their money. Mm-hmm. And not only that, it's also the prices of everything. All the materials and all the supplies that we need, they went up like crazy.
When I was growing up here in the neighborhood, I remember, you know, that's when the Clear Backpack started at Curie High School. But I knew people from that high school, and most of the kids were just like me. Mm-hmm. It's almost like, you know, the environment around the school, you know, imposed a narrative onto the student body. So, you know, as you mentioned, just having a business has so much that goes into it, so much struggle that goes into it, but your reasons for doing this and for struggling through this business, I couldn't thank you enough as someone that grew up, you know, not, you know, around this neighborhood. Mm-hmm. And we were always bored. We always had nothing to do. So on that note, you know, you run the Curie Local School Council, and, you know, it seems like it's a big part of this endeavor. What message would you want to give to the students, you know, past current and you know, future?
Well, past students, they made me always so happy. You know, having students here is like, it's like such a joy, because they always, when they come, it's like the place is like really happy. All the kids here doing homework or you know, laughing with the friends, making jokes, even dancing when they like the music. So past students have made me so happy, and I made so many friendships with the students, so many friendships. And current students, please keep supporting our business. This is a safe place. This is a place that is, that it was created like thinking of them, thinking of them having a nice space so they can bring the friend, bring the girlfriend, bring the boyfriend. So
definitely need it.
Just keep supporting this business and all the businesses in the area.
Okay, I thought that was a really good conversation. We are outside of De Colores on the patio at the corner of Archer and 49th. So, Jose, you had the talk with Dolores. What were some things that that stuck out to you from the conversation?
Yeah, I hadn't realized that she had served on the local school council at Curie that long, which makes sense. You know, we knew this was supposed to be a third place for the students of Curie, but just how deep that the foundation for that cause goes was great to hear about. We're also across the street, you know, right across Archer is Curie Park. It's a little bare, but hopefully this summer, you know, it's May, sun's coming out, you'll see a lot of activity there to try to get some community gardening stuff going on.
Yeah, for sure. That would be great to see. And again, De Colores is right at the corner of Archer and 49th. It's very close to Curie High School. It's very close to the Pulaski Orange Line stop. It's right in the middle of a lot of activity. So, you know, as the summer gears up, they are reopened. And, you know, please come on by. They're big supporters of the collective. And we'd love to see people come out and support them.
Thanks.